Given what the money is presently being spent on, the exponential growth and capacity that we've experienced in the last couple of years, play it out 2, 3, 5 years, where do you think the biggest advances are going to be?
So first thing I'll say is there's no guarantee that all this money in is going to lead to an output. It might, there'll probably be some output, but I'll just as a cautionary tale, remind you that driverless cars have been around for a long time. In 2016, I said, you know, even though these things look good right now, I'm not sure they're going to be commercialized anytime soon because there's an outlier problem. And the outlier problem is there's always some scenarios you haven't seen before. And the driverless cars continue to be plagued by this stuff 7 years later. You know, I gave an example then that Google had just maybe solved at that point a problem about recognizing piles of leaves on the road. And I said, there's going to be a huge number of these problems. We're never going to solve them. And we still haven't. So there was a Tesla that ran into a jet not that long ago because a jet wasn't in its training set. It didn't know what to do with it. It hasn't learned the abstract idea that driving involves not running into large objects. And so if there's a particular large object that isn't in its train set, it doesn't know what to do. So what happened there is $100 billion went into this. And still, the driverless car industry so far has just sucked in money and not actually made driverless cars that you can use in a reliable way. We may see that in large language models, or we may see that they can be used in limited circumstances, but not universally. So programmers are good, but take medicine. It's not clear that even GPT-5 is going to be a reliable source of medicine. 5 or 4 is actually better than 3, but is it reliable enough is an interesting question. You know, each year's driverless car is better than the last, but is it reliable enough? You know, not so far. And so whether you make that threshold in a domain where it's really safety critical is unclear. So there's definitely going to be things we get out of it, but there's also risks.
What I am hearing pretty consistently, and I think it certainly aligns with what you're telling me today, is that humans in the loop remain essential for almost all of the uses of AI that we're really benefiting from.
Yeah, that's true for large language models. You could argue that the routing systems that you use in your GPS, that just works. Like, you don't need a human in the loop there. Same with a chess computer. You can just play the chess computer. You don't need a human there. Large language models are actually special in their unreliability. They're arguably the most versatile AI technique that's ever been developed, but they're also the least reliable AI technique that's ever gone mainstream. And so everything where we're using large language models, we do for now need humans in the loop.